How do you think this will affect the actual structure of a workplace?
I think it's not going to be a one-size-fits-all model. You know, you're not going to be forced to go to the workplace. You're not going to be forced to work from home. The future of work is in the work itself. Just get the work done, show results, and then you can do what you want. Work from Japan if you want. It just doesn't matter as long as you can get that job done. That is the most important thing. And there was an article in the Financial Times that shows that recruiters now are looking for people who have the outcomes, who can actually show results for what they do. And that's what they really care about. And so it doesn't matter, 9 to 5, the whole idea of a 9 to 5 just doesn't really hold up in a world that we're all we're all connected by technology. You know, when I used to work for EMC, I'd have a call to Japan at 2 in the morning. I mean, when you're not at work, you're still doing work. You know, there was a study that was in Nashville last year that showed most people on vacation are still answering business email. You're always kind of doing work. And so because you're doing, you know, that type of work outside of your company, inside your company, you should do more personal things. And what happens when all that collides is you should just be more in control, because there's you know, personal and professional are coming together, and everything is getting more complicated, and really it needs to be custom for each person. And that's what millennials want. They want custom solutions for themselves. I mean, we think about even retail, you know, Macy's, all these big brands are customizing, Campbell's Soup, customizing products and the way they present themselves for millennials, because it's such an important demographic. And millennials, like, you know, Amazon wins with millennials too, because it's custom. It's like, here's a personalized page for you. And that's what works.
Sounds great, Dan. Last week, Time Magazine came out with a cover story dubbing Gen Y as the mean generation because of their confidence and independent way of thinking. How do you think this will affect the way they collaborate and team building skills in the future?
I think, you know, judging by the research that, you know, we've done in secondary research, they're the generation of collaborators. You know, even though they are independent, they wanna you know, use and leverage the talents of their peers too. They're always connected, right? And so these are individuals who are using instant messaging, Skype, all these different tools in order to collectively solve problems and the world's problems. They really want to have that type of impact, that social impact. And so I think it's going to, you know, bring people closer together, and we're going to see an uptick in it. You know, you see it here at Business Insider. I'm starting to see it at even bigger companies. And in order to compete, for the first time, you're seeing big companies compete against even freelancers or, you know, startups. And they're becoming, you know, the most successful companies are going to have startups within big companies. Like Google's model works really well, where you feel like you're working for a startup, but you're in that big corporate brand. And that's really what is going to drive millennials, because it's going to be less about what company you work for and who you're working with. And in that collaborative setting, that's going to be the most important thing. And based on how well you work in a team and accomplish different goals, that's what you're going to be judged by. And going back to what we said earlier, those outcomes are going to be the differentiator between someone who's successful and someone who's not.
And that'd be very